Thank you. pray that God will touch you tonight. That you're coming here in your life, you know, you may be saved. That tonight will be a remarkable moment in your life. In Jesus' name we are praying. In Jesus' name we are praying. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. The God of mercy is our God. There is a man in our midst. I'm overwhelmed. It's like I'm still dreaming. For those of you from Africa, for those of you from Nigeria, for us to have our daddy in our midst tonight is what we cannot expect. This is God's divine favor. To Nazareth. Will any good thing come out from Nazareth? We are here in Musafa. Maybe we are the underprivileged one, I don't know. But we say, will any good thing happen in Musafa? But the Lord God of mercy will make it possible. Yeah. Can you shout out? If you ask me how did our daddy the Lord be in our midst today, I have no answer to it. I don't know, I have no answer to it. We don't have more time, but I want to briefly introduce a general of our time. A man that his name is a collateral. Integrity. A man that millions of believers in the Lord look up to. A man that have turned the life of many around for good for Jesus Christ. A man that have raised general in this end time mission. People of God, believer of God, is not the right at all. It's a privilege and God divine favor for me to introduce the general overshadow of Hassan Name Chong, which you know, deep power life. A man that has gone all over the world. All over. Our daddy is in our midst tonight. Pastor, Doctor, W.A. Come on.
Something great, something good in every life. And for our brethren who are not English speaking, I hope the message is coming to you in your good, wonderful language. Thank God for the worship time. And thank God for that special number. Some of you that didn't understand because of lack of understanding. You wonder, what are they singing? We are praising the Lord. And it was acceptable praise, worship unto the Lord. Sweet in the ears of the Lord. And the leaders in the ears of angels. Praise the Lord. Tonight, we don't have too much time, but in the short time we have, the Lord will speak to you. Yeah. He's going to touch your life around. Yeah. Let's pray together. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you at this time. We bless your name. We're asking, Lord, that you will speak to every heart. That none of us will miss your blessing tonight in Jesus' name. Yeah. I thank you because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
Please let's be seated. I'm looking at Acts of the Apostles, chapter 19. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 19. And I'm reading the first part of verse 2. Here is Paul the Apostle, who found some disciples. Some worshippers, some Christians, some believers in Ephesus. He looked at them. He looked into them. He sought them out. They had one question to ask them. And as you come to worship the Lord, rejoice before the Lord, you want to ask yourself that same question, because whether you like it or not, whether I like it or not, this question will come back to us here in life and also in the great beyond. Look at Acts chapter 19, verse 2. And he said unto them, have ye received the Holy Ghost since ye believe? Look at that again. Have you received the Holy Ghost when you believe? Since you believe? Now that you believe, have you received the Holy Ghost? I want to examine with you the question, have you received the Spirit? The Christian faith is not a mental faith. The Christian faith is not a head, accent, or believing. The many people that are into this philosophy, or this religion, or this ideology, or this form of worship, whether they go by the name Christian or they go by another name. But we need to understand that the Christian faith goes beyond the mind. It goes beyond a tenet or a kind of collection of philosophies, ideologies, and ideas. It goes beyond the mind or the head. It deals with the heart, deals with the spirit, and deals with the spirit of God. That's why it's very important for us to understand, have you received the spirit? It doesn't say, have you heard about, have you thought about, have you analyzed? It's receiving. Let me talk about the spirit. The spirit is not like a wind. It's not like a force. It's not like fire. It's not like a material thing. As you look at your Bible, the spirit speaks. The spirit can be grieved. You can love the spirit. You can fellowship with the Spirit. You cannot fellowship with wood. You cannot fellowship with the world. You cannot fellowship with the fire. You cannot fellowship with material things. You can only fellowship with a person, a personality. They asked a class of young people a question. They said, what is fellowship? And one boy raised up his hand. He said, fellowship is two people, two fellows in the same ship. Fellowship. Two fellows in the same ship. I think that's a good answer from the church. And what's fellowship with the Holy Spirit? You remember when we say grace? Say the grace with me. The love of God. Tell me out loud. The fellowship of the Holy Spirit. Fellowship. And what's fellowship? Two people in the same ship. Isn't that right? So, if we talk about the Spirit, He talks to us. He guides us. He leads us. He comforts us. Think about that one. He comforts us. Something that doesn't have life cannot comfort you. If you have sorrow, if you are depressed, you have a problem, you have a challenge, something that can't talk, can't understand, can't see, can't feel, can't sympathize, it cannot comfort you. But we talk of the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete, the Comforter. When He's come, He will guide you. And so, we're talking about a person, a divine personality. And the question is, have you received the Spirit? We don't have time. I'm going to talk on three things. Number one, the Spirit of Christ. The Spirit of Christ. When we say, have you received the Spirit? There are many kinds of spirits. There is the human spirit, and there is the Holy Spirit. And the spirit we're talking about here is the Holy Spirit, not the human spirit. Have you received the Spirit? Number one, the Spirit of Christ. Number two, the Spirit of Comfort. The Spirit of Comfort. Because Jesus spoke over and over and over again. And He says, He is the comfort. In the original language, the Paraclete. When we say para, para in the original language means that is alongside with you. He's staying by your side to help. He's staying by your side to lift you up. He's staying by your side to hold you and keep you together. Sometimes you want to come apart because things are overwhelming in your life. But He stays by your side, Paraclete, to help. The helper that goes along with us, the Comforter. The Spirit of Comfort. Number one. What's number one?
The Spirit of Christ.
The Spirit of Christ. Number two.
The Spirit of Comfort.
Number three is the Spirit of the Conqueror. The Spirit of the Conqueror. All the apostles came to the midst of these believers, and from their complaints, their dejection, their sorrows, they were downhearted. And it's like, how are we going to make it till tomorrow? Look at all the challenges around us. Look at this pressure and this challenge and this difficulty and all these things that we have around. And when you looked at them and saw a kind of despair, you're supposed to have the Spirit if you're a Christian. He said, tell me something. Have you received the Spirit of the Conqueror, that no matter what is happening, you know, we are on the winning side. And I want to tell you tonight, it doesn't matter what faces you or what you face. Doesn't matter what you're leaving behind or what you look at in the future, there is somebody who has conquered. Yes, on the inside of us. That's why you wonder, are you Christians? Are you children of God? Have you received the Spirit since you believed? If you have not, we're going to turn it around from a question to a statement. Receive the Spirit since you believe. You understand?
Amen.
Have you received the Spirit since you believe? Alright, if you have not, now we're turning to a statement. Receive the Spirit since you believe.
Amen.
Lord, I believe.
Amen.
Anybody believing there?
Amen.
Yes, you believe. It will be so in Jesus' name. Number one, the Spirit of Christ. Look at Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8. I'm reading from verse 9. But ye are not in the flesh, but in the Spirit. If so be that the Spirit of God dwell in you. Now, if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, is none of his. If any man have not the Spirit of Christ, is none of his. The question is, what's the Spirit of Christ? How do you recognize the Spirit of Christ? Because it says, if anyone may claim to be anything or anybody, may claim any title or any name, he claims the name, I am a child of God. I hear you, but I'm looking for something else. Another person says, I am a Catholic. I hear you. I'm asking for something else. Another one says, see me. I am charismatic and Pentecostal. I understand. We're asking for something else. Have you received the Spirit since you believe? What kind of Spirit? The Spirit of Christ. Turn it around. Explain it to yourself. The Spirit of hatred, that's not of Christ. The Spirit of violence, that cannot be the Spirit of Christ. The Spirit of the Antichrist, we hear that the Antichrist will come. And right now, John says, the Spirit of that Antichrist is already in the world. And he says, it's not asking whether you receive the Spirit of the Antichrist will be a deceiver. The spirit of deception, that one is not of Christ. Which one is the Spirit of Christ? You begin to check up, let's leave all the titles. You know, I am a bishop myself, I like to be a bishop. I'm an archbishop, I like to be an archbishop too. I am a prophet of a great title, but let's not play with words tonight. Let's leave all titles aside. The question is, have you received the Spirit? The Spirit of Christ. How do I know the manifestation of the Spirit of Christ? Because it says over here, if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, he is none of his. He doesn't belong to him. In Galatians chapter 5, here we read from verse 21. Galatians chapter 5, verse 21. It says, now the Spirit, the fruit of the Spirit is, tell me what you find there. Tell me what you find there. The Spirit, the fruit of the Spirit is love. That's the Spirit of Christ. In fact, Jesus said, by this you will know that you are my disciples, and other people will know that you are disciples if you love one another as I have loved you. And how many people go by the name Christian, minister, bishop, archbishop, prophet, and this identifying mark of a disciple of Christ is not present, then love is not there. Husband and wife, when you fight, separate, divorce, where is the love? Children and parents, when we throw stones at each other, insult our parents. Or the parents brutalize the children. The question is, where is the love? And if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, it's none of his. And the fruit of the Spirit, number one, is, tell me again,
love.
And you know, love, we don't need a dictionary to know love. From the first expression, from you to another person, the smile, the affection, I'm happy to see you. And you're really happy, and you can tell. The body language tells about the love. The expression, the things we say, the thoughts we have, that we express, the helping hand we give. Can I assist you there? Can I help you there? And you say, thank you. What are you thanking me for? You make me glad by allowing me to help you. You make my day because you give me a chance to do what I love to do. You know, you give a helping hand to somebody and it says, get this. You say, what's that for? It says, I'm giving you money. You say, why? It says, because of what you've done for me. It says, what? My doing it makes me feel good, makes me feel alive. So paying me for something is like you gave me food, because love is the food of the soul. Love is the food of the spirit. It's love that builds us up. It's like ointment, like nutrition. It's like tonic. It does something for you. And when you give me a chance to love you, you're helping me, and you cannot pay me for that. That's the reason why it says the Spirit of Christ. See how Jesus went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil. It gave me fulfillment to do that. When you have that Spirit of Christ, love is not something I'm trying to love him. It's unlovable. I'm trying to love him. It's so hard loving so and so, I'm telling you. When the Spirit of Christ is there, this is why Paul said, Paul looked at the midst of the people, all the argument, criticism, infighting, division, and conflict. The pastor must go, why is the pastor acting like that? And that other one says, this other one is having too much attention. Paul the apostle said, tell me something. Have you received the Spirit since you believed? He said, we have not even so much as heard. Oh, no wonder. The things I see among you and the stories I hear shows me that you need the Spirit. We need the Spirit.
Yeah.
I said, we need the Spirit.
Yeah.
It says, the fruit of the Spirit is love. He goes on to say, and then joy. Joy. What's joy? As we look at that joy, J-O-Y. That J is for Jesus. That Y is you. That O is nothing in between. Joy is Jesus and you with nothing in between. Now, joy is different from happiness. Happiness, you know, happiness depends on happenings. The things that are happening, they give you happiness. Money, I'm happy. Somebody gave me a gift of a suit. I never saw a suit like this before. Happiness, I'm happy. But joy. Jesus and you was nothing in between. That's why Paul the Apostle said, as if we had nothing, and yet we have everything. Why? Because Jesus is all in all. I have Jesus, I have everything. You see, man, he comes into the fellowship, he's singing, he's swimming in his hand, he's swimming in his hand, and then you check up, they just give him a termination letter in his place of work, and he comes in here, he's hilarious, he's excited, he's exuberant, he's worshiping the Lord, he loves the Lord, and then you whisper to another person, if you knew what happened to him yesterday, you will know that this is real joy. The joy of the Lord is your strength. But the happiness, you know, whatever happens, happiness or whatever, I have joy. You have joy.
Yes,
that's the presence of the Spirit of God. When Paul the Apostle got to their midst, and they saw people drooping, and they're dreary, and they're weary, and it's like, you know, I'm carrying a load on my shoulders. It's like, you know, my back is bent. What will I face tomorrow? He said, tell me something here. Have you received the Spirit since you believe? When we receive the Spirit, it's the Spirit of Christ. There will be love, there will be joy. Look at the next thing here and it says, tell me the next word there. Peace. The peace that passes understanding. The people cannot understand you. That when everything appears turbulent on the face of the sea, deep down underneath the surface, there is calmness and there is peace. And nothing seems to bother you or worry you. You are not anxious, you are not worried. You just have peace. And somebody says, did you hear about this? God is on the throne. Did you know that this and this happened? God is on the throne. You are just peaceful. And then, look at Jesus Christ in the boat and there was storm. And then he was sleeping in the ship. The disciples came and woke him up. Don't you care that you perish? They were wondering that Jesus was not worried. And sometimes some people are worried that you are not worried.
Amen.
They say, have you heard? Oh, yes, I heard. But that's not the end of the story. Jesus is there. How do you expect the Prince of Peace to be as worried as you are? He will no more be the Prince of Peace if you are worried and he is worried. You are anxious and he is anxious. That's why he does that. And then he rose up there. There is power when you have peace. You know, there are people who try to pray with confusion in their mind. They try to pray and must have great faith. While there is confusion, confidence in God will flee away from your heart. But when there is peace, there is power in peace. That's why he rose up and said, peace. Remember who he's talking? He's the Prince of Peace. And he said, peace is still, everything was calm. And tonight, that Prince of Peace is here.
Yeah.
When we have the Prince of Peace with us, you know, why do people, I hear somebody going to the 28th, 28th floor of the building? And then he jumps down. Why? Because the Prince of Peace was not there. It's like, what am I living for? If you know that Christ is there, you will know that although it is dark now, in a few hours, sunshine will come. And you will know that as a child of God, although it appears difficult now, the solution is just by the God. Call the name of Jesus and everything will be over. And this is the Spirit we are talking about. That when you are a Christian, you are number one, the Spirit of Christ. There's love, there's joy, there's peace, there is even the next one there. Again?
Long suffering.
Okay. You know, sometimes when you say long suffering, long suffering, long suffering. You know the difference? Long suffering, that looks like short suffering. You understand? But long suffering. That's what there means. Do you understand?
Yes.
I want to hear you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Long suffering. Husband and wife, there's a little problem. And then I'm going to the marriage counselor. I said, what are you coming from? I'm coming from the marriage counselor. What's happening? This woman. There's something happening at all. I want to know whether I have the liberty to kick her out and my life. And I say, do you have the Spirit Oh, that's of course, yes. What kind of spirit? The spirit of short suffering, of long suffering. That you are there. It's not that everything is easy, but you've endured one day, one week, one month. How long is your long suffering? But when you are there and you know the solution will come, be patient with her, be patient with him, and understand that where the Spirit of the Lord is, that the Lord suffering, that it's not that every little thing that I want to see, that the same divorce rate in the church you find in the world. Tell me what's the difference. We say we are saved, they are not saved, but we have the same rate of divorce. We have the same rate of family violence. We have the same rate of suicide. And we are right and they are wrong. Tell me, it is not what you say, it is what we see happening. And I believe that from tonight, you have the Spirit of Christ, not suffering while the devil. It goes on to say, gentleness. I love that word, gentleness. I hope we'll be gentle. And goodness, and faith, and meekness, and temperance. That temperance is self-control. Against such, there is no. So, in answer to the question, have you received the Spirit, number one, the Spirit of Christ? The Spirit of Christ. Number two. What's number two? The Spirit of comfort. Now, it's good to, you know, when you have a problem, you go to the pastor talks to you, someone sympathizes with you. But who is a greater sympathizer? The pastor or the Holy Spirit?
The Holy Spirit,
theoretically. Because practically, we don't take our problems to the Holy Spirit, practically. Sometimes, I don't understand. We are as confused as the people outside there are confused. We are as perplexed as the people out there are perplexed. So where is then the ministry of the Holy Spirit in our lives? And I want to tell you that it doesn't matter. You are Pentecostal, you are charismatic, you are evangelical, you are Orthodox, you are historic, you are traditional church. They are all the same. When it comes to the comfort of the Holy Spirit, we should never hear about suicide in a Pentecostal congregation. Because the Holy Spirit is there. And if he's there, he comforts us. He explains what we don't understand and what we need to know. Why should this happen? The Holy Spirit will explain to you. Look at the people in the Bible that had the Holy Spirit. As we go back, far back to Genesis, that young man, his name, Joseph, look at the thing that happened to him. And you'll never see that young man ruffled, confused, perplexed, angry with anybody in those days on, living from day to day. He had a dream. And the things happening appear to contradict all the dream that he had. But no complaints, no confusion. And when he got to Potiphar's there, he just did the regular thing he ought to do. He got to the prison, no problem. He did the regular thing he ought to do. And eventually, the dream became fulfilled. And Pharaoh said something about him. Can we find another man that has the Spirit of God in him like this man? That man has the Spirit. Look at Daniel. You'll find Daniel, he prayed, and because of the prayer, they cast him into the lion's den. How do I understand? Lord, I'm doing good, and look at what's happening to me. I'm doing right, and look at what's happening to me. I'm spiritual, and look at what's happening to me. Daniel had no question. Had no confusion because the Spirit of comfort was abiding present within. So the same thing we should understand, that He is the comforter. There are many verses. I'm just reading one because of our time. We're looking at John, the Gospel according to St. John. Gospel according to St. John. And we're reading here from verse 26. Verse 26, but the comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. He is comforter. He will comfort you.
Amen.
I said he will comfort you. Wipe our tears away. We shouldn't be going to the people who are trained counselors. Trained counselors in psychology, in human problems or whatever. We should be the people that will carry the comforter along with us everywhere we go. And I pray it will be so in our lives in Jesus' name. Number one is the Spirit of Christ. And the question is, have you received the Spirit since you believe? Number two, the Spirit of Comfort. And now, number three, the Spirit of a Conqueror. I have conquered. And I will keep on conquering. You see, the believer is a conqueror. There should be nothing, no single solitary thing in this world, from sin to sickness to evil spirit to circumstances to situations to Satan, that should conquer the Christian. Because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world.
Amen.
We should experience that every time. And a dream in the night should not conquer a believer. A believer in our arm, I have a dream. They are after me. They keep this to me in the dream. If you don't see me tomorrow, it's the fulfillment of my dream. Hey, there's somebody in us that is different than a dream. I saw a woman in the dream, and this woman said this, that on my dead body, will you make success? Will you make this or make that? Anywhere you run to, you run from your country, and you run to this place, we're still after you. On my dead body, will you do this? And I would say, you prophesy it yourself. On your dead body, I will be successful. You want to die for my success? Good luck for you. But I will succeed. Anybody going to succeed? From their dead body, that's what they want. Because greater you see that is in you than he that's in the world. And you are more than a conqueror. Through Jesus Christ, if the Spirit abides in us, we conquer sickness. We conquer evil spirits. We conquer sin. Anything that comes, you'll see us standing as mighty conquerors. And tonight, that Spirit of the Conqueror is upon you.
Yeah.
In Romans chapter 8, I'm reading here from verse 37. Romans chapter 8, it says, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. Him that loved us. I want to talk on him that loved us. Let's say, for example, there are five people around you that are bold enough to tell you and say, hey, don't make a mistake. I hate you. Say, is that what you want to say? That's what I wanted to inform you. Another person says, my friend, no, not your friend. What do you mean? You're not my friend. I love everyone. Okay, you may love me, but I want to tell you, I hate you. If five people say categorically, with words, with facial appearance, with anything they can do, they say they hate you, and only Jesus loves you. Jesus or the five people, who is greater?
Jesus.
A 1,000 people cannot be equal to Jesus. The hatred of 1,000 people, 1,000,000 people is nothing a comparison of the law of Jesus Christ. If we know that and we believe that this one hates me, that one hates me, that other one hates me, and then I go to hide inside a room, you give yourself house arrest, house imprisonment. They will say, my friend, why don't you come out? They hate me. And you tell me, and I don't know what I'm going to do. And I don't know what they are bringing out of their pockets. And since those 10 people, they say they hate me, that's why I'm here. Then I ask you, what is Jesus who loves you? What is Jesus who makes you more than a conqueror? Open that door and come out. I said, open that door and come out. And then you stand like a conqueror. You see, when I was in ignorance, I was hiding inside there. But now, the truth has set me free. He shall know the truth, and the truth shall make him free. Now I come up. Whatever you want to do, I have the lion of the tribe of Judah. He lives on the inside of me. And I'm more than a conqueror. Sickness under my feet. Satan under my feet. All those circumstances under my feet. Now the people will know by your language, by what you say, by what you think, they know you have the spirit of the conqueror. Number one, the spirit of Christ. Number two, the spirit of conqueror. Number three, of a conqueror. You have, you possess all that, you are victor any day, anywhere you go. Let's rise up and pray. The Spirit of Christ. The Spirit of Christ. The Spirit of comfort. And the Spirit of the Conqueror.
The Spirit of comfort. The Spirit of Christ, Father. I receive it, mighty God. I
receive
it, all over, Father. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, I receive the Spirit of God. The Spirit of Christ. The Spirit of peace. The Spirit of joy. The Spirit of comfort.
May the meekness, may the temperance self-control. The Spirit of Christ. The Spirit of comfort. The comforted. The comfort. The sympathizing spirit will dwell inside you. No confusion, no anxiety, no worry, no conflict. Of the past, the darkness of the past, the fear of the past. all gone and buried for tonight. Lord, the touch of heaven will come upon every life right now in Jesus' name. Be turning around from within. That the Spirit of Christ will enter, will come into everyone to stay, to abide, to dwell, even from tonight in Jesus' name. Plant your love in our hearts. Grant everyone the joy of the Lord. Show peace, the peace that passes understanding, reign in every life from tonight in Jesus' name. Comfort those who are sorrowful. Wipe away their tears. To the father, to the fatherless. The husband, to the widows. For those who are facing any challenge, Lord, I pray the storm of their lives will come to an end. There is something definite in every life. There will be a calm. The storm is over. The crying is over. Complexity of your life is over. And I say and I pray, you'll see a tangible, measurable, visible change in all your circumstances from tonight in Jesus' name. Now, Lord, the Spirit of the Conqueror. The Spirit that will not be conquered, but will conquer sin. Conquer sickness,
amen.
Conquer evil spirits,
amen.
Conquer Satan,
amen.
Conquer in all situations.
Amen.
Lord, I pray that your people, one by one, men and women, will receive that conquering spirit right now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Any sickness in your body, I speak directly to that sickness.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Come out. Any evil spirit, any evil power tormenting your life, harassing your life, I command right now. Come out in Jesus' name. Set your people free. Raise everyone from the dunghill to the throne of glory. Let the strength of the Lord, the might of the Lord, the power of the Lord abide with everyone. Make everyone the victor.
Yeah.
The overcomer.
Yeah.
The conqueror.
Yeah.
Give us the realization that he who lives in us is greater than he who lives in the world.
Yeah.
Lord, we receive.
Yeah.
Lord, we receive.
Yeah.
The Spirit of Christ, I receive.
Yeah.
The Spirit of comfort, I receive.
Yeah.
The Spirit of the Conqueror, I receive.
Amen.
Confirm it in every life.
Amen.
In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Take care of it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So let's
meet after this meeting, and we are still going to make some contact with all the leaders of the committee so that this opportunity will not pass over in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Please, I want you to understand, if our daddy is about to leave, we want you to be seated. Let there be orderliness in the house of God. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So please, if our daddy said he's leaving, I want everybody to be seated while we sing off, then to give the necessary announcement again. There's another one. Then, in the God of mercy, will give us praise in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Can we shout God of mercy 5 times as I hand over to Pastor Jesus? You want to go?
The God of mercy, the God of mercy, the God of mercy, the God of mercy, the God of mercy is our God.
Pastor Jesus, please. Can you clap up for Jesus?
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What a privilege. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I would like to ask you to stand up. Let's pray for the man of God. Praise the name of the Lord. Dr. Pastor W.F. Komi, as he has watered you, let's lift our hands unto the Lord concerning the Lord shall water him in Jesus' name. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He shall wax greater and greater in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You are going to pray for his ministry. The Lord shall continue to enlarge his host in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let's lift up our hands and pray for the man of God. Father, we just want to bless you for your mercy upon our life today. To host a great man of God, a servant of the Most High God in our midst. Father, we thank you for your grace. Thank you, Father, for your word. Thank you, Father, for the word that has come forth, the word that transforms. Thank you, Lord, for what you have begun in our lives. Thank you, Father, for every victory that you have given us tonight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Therefore, Lord, we ask you, O God, Father, even as your son, your servant, Father, whom he has watered your people, Father, we pray that you shall water him.
For your anointment that have flowed from your altar. Father, your name be praised forever in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, King of glory, as we have been a partaker of this great blessing, Father, King of glory shall be permanent in our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Any gathering from the pit of hell, every gathering of Satan the devil, Father, to hijack this blessing, to hijack this breakthrough, this anointing that are free in our lives today, in the mighty name of Jesus, we come against them. We scatter them by fire, by thunder, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, this testimony will ever be afresh in our life. Father, King of glory, because we are here, breakthrough is our portion, prosperity is our portion. Every door that has seen knock in our life, in the name of Jesus, because we are here, In the name of Jesus Christ, because you are here, we will know that. We will never regret. We will never shed tears again. All the problems, suffering of the past have passed away. Everything has become new unto us because we are here, because of your name's sake. In the name of Jesus Christ, thank you, Ancient of Days, for you have done it again. Your name be praised forever, ever and ever. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen. Let us shout it. The God of mercy. The God of mercy, the God of mercy, the God of mercy, the God of mercy, our God, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. The time is well spent, so let's just take our offering and then we make the closing prayer. Hallelujah. The baskets are moving around. Praise God.
The God of mercy, the God of mercy, the God of mercy.
the God of mercy, the God of mercy, the God, the blood of Jesus Christ, 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 the blood of Jesus Christ shall continue to speak for us. Let's shout the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, in the 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 name of Jesus Christ, we are more than conquerors. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. You are blessed because you came. Amen. God bless you so much.
Today is a remarkable day for my life to meet with a man of God, Pastor Kumuyi. I just want to thank God for this meeting, that indeed God is real. I just want to thank Almighty Jehovah for his blessing, for his mercy. I just want to thank God for his grace that is upon us. I thank God the meeting went fine. Everybody is blessed. I thank Almighty Jehovah for successful meeting. The man of God came and he ministered to us. He tell us more about Christ. Now we still have opportunity to know more about Christ. He break everything down for us. For us to know more about Christ. For those that backslided, they have to buckle up because of today's message. The today message give us more lighting concerning Christ. I thank God for every good thing. I thank God for his life. And I pray that Almighty God will keep him alive to continue to do his good work in the name of Jesus Christ. And I just want to thank the crowd of His glory. I want to thank the man of God that is here, Pastor Matthew Ataya Leto, Pastor Josue, and all the workers for make everything successful for today, for us to enable us to host the great man of God, Kumuyi. I just want to thank everybody. May the name of the God be praised forever in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Because in our time, the great man of God has come to minister to us. I will give God the praise. May his name forever and ever be praised forever. In Jesus' name we are prayed. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, I thank God today for his mercy upon the cloud of his glory. Prayer house, the God of mercy. Thank God for the life of our pastor, Pastor Matthew, for the opportunity God gave to him to bring Pastor Kumuyi to bless us today. We are really blessed for his message. And thank God for his ministration. Speak concerning the Spirit of God if we have received the Spirit. And I believe that every one of us that listen to his message today, I was blessed by his message and we received the Holy Spirit. His way going back, may the Lord give him message journey. Thank God for asking that call. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Very much praise be a part of this meeting. And I believe I'm blessed and my life is totally transformed. It's my great experience to be in the presence of great man of God, Dr. W.F. Kumuyi. He's a really great man of God. The message was great and powerful. I thank God for my life. Today I'm very much happy. And today is important. It's one of the best and important day of my life. I thank God for being a part of this meeting. Thank you so much.